They didn't see it coming. The Ashanti were their friends until they pulled their fire-sticks out and did far from make amends. And just like that, Amari lost her destiny, drifting from her family and heading out to sea. She met a girl named Daffy who held her head up high, teaching Amari lessons that would help soon in time. They're out in Charlestown where the slave auction was held. Mr. Derby bought Amari for a slave 16, and on the way to Dimashev every night in Clay Derby's room. The chairs, the whips, the pain, the tears forced upon the innocent who try to hide their fears. Death, hate, the longing to escape, the dreams of Fort Mose. Polly had her dreams. With Polly by her side, and when she woke, Clay Derby came with evil in his eyes. He grew up 4-year-old timid as Gator Bay, and Amari wants to tag along and watch little Tippett's pain. The chains, the whips, the pain, the tears forced upon Amari saw some trouble coming down the road. Clay Derby held the baby. Mr. Derby got extremely angry. He went inside and got his dreadful gun. He shot the newborn baby and her father, Isabel. The chains, the whips, the pain, the tears forced upon the innocent who try to hide their fears. Death, hate, the longing to escape, the dreams of Fort Mose. Amari, Polly, and Tippett were supposed to be sold, but the doctor told them to run north to escape. They made it, and they were free. Fort Mose wasn't like it seemed, but they were finally free. And Ned helped them get comfortable, and even told Amari she was with child. Amari was upset at first, but realized this child would always come first. She'd have this child. the sun, the thrill, the truth.